Hey, what's up guys, Benny here, and welcome to today's Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War video, where I'm gonna be showing you what I've found are the game's two most overpowered weapons and class setups in the entire game right now. What I'm also trying to figure out is which weapons are going to work really well in Warzone when they get added to the game on December 10th. But the weapons and class setups that I'm about to show you will help you do very well in multiplayer so you can rank up and do as well as you possibly can in Cold War. But before we get into the first weapon, 75% of you watching are not subscribed to the channel, so smash that button and I promise you, you'll get better at Call of Duty. Okay, we need to start with what I think we can all tell is Black Ops Cold War's best weapon, and surprise, surprise, it's the MP5. And I genuinely think this could rival the MP5 from Modern Warfare. So, some things to know about this weapon. Firstly, is it's going to deal 32 damage a bullet, which is what's helping to give it very fast time to kill, especially up to around 18 meters with the build that I'm about to show you. So you're going to dominate at those close ranges, perfect in 6v6 maps like Crossroads, but will struggle when it gets a little further away, just like an SMG should, but it's got an insane fire rate of 857 rounds per minute. The recoil is also pretty easy to control, and with the gun being available straight away, this is a gun you should rank up as soon as possible. And that's one thing I will say with Black Ops Cold War. Ranking your weapons and leveling in general takes a really long time, so try to stick to a couple weapons at a time so that you can get all the attachments. A big tip I would give you in Cold War, and you'll notice it from my gameplay, is try not to slide into fights, as that did get nerfed with the launch of the game, as you won't be able to ADS as quickly as you'd like, and also try and control areas. With skill-based matchmaking in effect as well, constantly challenging fights is not going to work for you, and try and use jump shots rather than drop shots, because unless you've got the right attachment on it, you can't do your drop shot anymore. Also, if you want to get some extra free kills for your stats, remember, getting a stun on an opponent that your teammate kills will also count as a kill to you. But this is the MP5 that I would recommend you use, which is a bit of an all-rounder. So this is my MP5 loadout, and I'm going to start off with the wild card, because I think in Cold War loadouts, the wild card is kind of like the base. It's one of the most important parts of your class, because it's going to change how you build it, to be perfectly frank. So I've gone for Gunfighter with this current one now. I think with a lot of SMGs, you could potentially see people starting to run Perk Greed, because there are some perks that you're like, oh, I want kind of both of them. So this could potentially be one that we see used a lot, but with assault rifles, it's going to be Gunfighter all the way. Attachments are king. Like, you'll use a weapon with no attachments and it will suck. Then you put all the attachments on it and it becomes an absolute beast. So make sure you go with Gunfighter. Then on the MP5 itself, what I found for the optic, the best optic is the Microflex LED. Now, this is a really, really clean sight. Now, if you're going for a red dot sight, this is the one that you want to go for. Like, I find the quick dots and all this sort of stuff, they're a little bit too small and you miss important details. This is really clean. You'll have seen it in the gameplay before. It's such a good sight. So make sure you use the Microflex. If you found any others that you personally prefer, let me know down in the comments below. Then for the muzzle, I've gone for the Infantry Compensator. Now, if we go for the details, it gives us a plus 12% vertical recoil control and minus 8% to horizontal recoil control. Now, it doesn't really move side to side. It kind of bounces up and down. So this kind of levels it out and just kind of allows you to kind of beam your opponents. As you can kind of see here, like the horizontal recoil is non-existent and really easy to manage. And also, you kind of want to go up and down more. So go for the Infantry Compensator. Then on the barrel itself, the Reinforced Heavy is what I think is the best one to go for. It gives you 18% effective damage range, so your 32 damage bullet distant bullets are going to be at a further distance, really good, and also faster bullet velocity. So your bullets are going to be a bit more hit scan. They're going to go where you're shooting them. So really, really good barrel to have. I've just deselected it. But on the body, now this is one that can potentially change. Now, if you find yourself hip firing a lot, this steady aim laser is really good. However, something that I have been finding with assault rifles especially is using the spotlights, because you'll see a little dot above their head. If you want to do that, mount a flashlight. I've personally been using the steady aim laser because I hip fire a lot, works really well for me, so go for that. The underbarrel, you just want that foregrip. Horizontal recoil control, absolutely no cons. It's only going to be a good thing for you. So go for the standard foregrip. Magazine, I go for the SAS mag clamp. Now, I was using the 40 barrel mag, but sometimes the reload is really slow. So if you take out multiple opponents, you just can't really get the next mag in. This is 40% quicker and also gives you some more starting ammo as well with only a minus 6% aim down sight time. Now, most of the time with a SMG, I'm already shooting as I go to ADS, so it's not too big of a deal losing that ADS time, or I'm pre-aiming and pre-firing. So SAS mag clamp, brilliant mag to have on the MP5. Then the handle, I've got the field tape, which is flinch resistance. It just means if I'm in a 50-50 gunfight, my gun's not going to go anywhere and I'm going to land my shots and come out on top. Really useful. And then on the stock, I've got the clap stock. It feels like I'm in Modern Warfare. Clap stock with for a faster sprint to fire time. The dust stock's also quite interesting if you want to start sliding a little bit more. Personally, I just kind of like that sprint to fire time so I can get my shots off a little bit quicker. But as you can see, if we have a look at the details, overall, really, really good MP5 build. I forgot. I took my body off. Let me stick that back on. No. And I took my optic off. It's an easy thing to do with this, I have to admit. So we'll go for that. No, I've chosen the wrong one. We want the Microflex LED. Secondary weapons, I've not really, if I'm honest, I don't really use the secondaries. Now, I like having the Sigma on just because it means that I can counter vehicles if I have to. But you'll notice one of the big things that I'm doing with most of my classes at the moment is in Perk 3 and running cold-blooded. Now, the reason I do that is because of the score streak system, everyone's getting choppers, especially mid-game. It's almost worth having two classes. For the first half of the game, use a ghost or ninja class. Ninja's really good. And then switch to cold-blooded once people start getting their choppers in. Because of the score streak system, they just get it in so quickly, it hurts. But flat jacket, scavenger, cold-blooded, then stun grenades. Personally, not loving the C4. I'd prefer to use a Semtex. Frag grenade's good, but the problem is it takes a bit of a time to throw, which can be a problem. And then personally, I haven't accessed this before. Field mic is the best one for me, especially on the small maps. It means you can just kind of cover your back where people are likely going to be. And that is my MP5 loadout. It's an absolute beastly setup. Make sure to try it out. But now, let's check out the next gun. Now, with Black Ops Cold War, I almost feel like I've been thrown back to the original Modern Warfare because, wow, the M16... is overpowered. I mean, this thing isn't even the assault rifle category, but is easily the best assault rifle in the entire game. Firstly, it deals 50 damage per bullet, which means, yes, you do have the ability to one burst opponents if you're within the gun's effective range and land all three shots from the burst to the upper chest. But most of the time, it's going to take two bursts. But that's all good, because the M16 I'm going to show you has a fire rate of 1,034 rounds per minute, which is obscene. It just means that you can take down multiple enemies at a time with no problem at all. What I would say is it does require you to be accurate with your shots, as that time between bursts does give an opponent a chance to take you down. And I honestly think it's a gun that could carry across the Warzone quite nicely, even though currently, burst guns haven't performed that well in Warzone in the past. But one thing I will say is with the M16 is that it's a weapon that you really want to use when you're trying to hold down an area. Its sprint to fire time is quite slow at 440 milliseconds, and with a large amount of the lobbies running SMGs like the MP5, you're going to get taken out if you're caught sprinting. So, just like in a lot of the gameplay that you're seeing, try to get towards a point on the map that's a power position and has a good amount of cover. And you can see multiple map choke points and you're going to get a lot of kills. But let me show you the setup that I'm using with this absolute beast of a weapon. Now, this is my M16 loadout that I absolutely love, by the way. It's probably my favorite class setup in the game right now. And as I said, I am getting those COD 4 throwback moments when you're just kind of taking on multiple opponents and it is probably the best assault rifle in the game, even though it's in the tactical rifle slot. I don't know why it's not an assault rifle, but it's here. And you'll also notice that I am using the Western Front blueprint, which is kind of how I got started using it and got a few extra attachments early on. But if we go into Gunsmith, I'm using that mils.reflex sight. It's really, really clean. I haven't really tried many of the other scopes with the M16, if I'm honest. I'm tempted to try like the Vision Tech and the Axial Arms because I think those are going to be more used for Warzone because all the maps really are quite small. You don't really need those long distance scopes in multiplayer right now in the 6v6 modes anyway. On the muzzle, I'm using the SOCOM Eliminator, which is 85% muzzle flash concealment and then 17% vertical recoil control. It just means I'm kind of harder to spot when I'm kind of like anchoring a position. You know, I found it works quite well for me, and also that vertical recoil control just helps keep that burst when I'm like firing rapidly centered, so I'm going to be landing all three shots on the burst as frequently as possible. Then if we go to the barrel, I've got that rapid fire barrel. There's no cons to it. It's going to allow me to get more shots off quicker. I am very, very tempted. This right here, the 20.5 task force, is definitely going to be the one for Warzone, by the way. Throw a suppressor on it as well, but like increased fire rate, really important. I didn't go for this, even though it's a faster fire rate, because it's a drop in 25% of effective damage range. You want to be getting those one-shot bursts as far as possible. So personally, this 16.3 rapid fire works well for me. Now, I've started using the mounted flashlight, and you'll see it in my gameplay. Is the reason I do that is because I'm like kind of from the hip, and it will mark opponents that I sometimes might miss. This works really well on maps like Cartel, where there's loads of bushes, and you can just see a light, bright red icon where an enemy is. Really useful, actually. I wouldn't go for like the target designation because you've got to be aiming down sight for that. This is just going to allow you to scan the map a lot more and spot enemies a lot easier, which leads to more kills. Then on the underbelt, front grip, horizontal recoil control. Once again, it's just going to help center those bursts so you're kind of landing all three shots exactly where you want to. Works really, really well for me. Then on the mag, I'm using the 45 round mag. Now, I think that's what the best one for this. It means you lose a bit of reload quickness, but really you've got like 15 bursts every single clip. It's enough to take down like four or five players. So yeah, 45 round mag, brilliant if you're using the gunfighter. Wildcard. Then on the handle, I've got the Serpent Wrap. Now, that's for a fast aim down sight time because I'm not sprinting into a gunfight very often. So as an assault rifle player, I'm holding it going from the hip. So because of the flashlight, and that's just allowing me to snap onto my opponents. It works so well. I can't stress that enough. And then on the stock, I've got the tactical stock for 65% aim walking movement speed. So I can kind of strafe a little bit better. It's a bit like having Stalker in previous games. Honestly, a really good all-round build on the M16. This is actually what I've managed to get my highest gun streak with so far, which I think is like a 23 or 24, which I got on stream in the tournament. Then once again, secondary, I'd just go for a launcher right now. I've not really spent much time with this, but a shotgun would be useful if you're in like a inside of a plane on checkmate or something like that. That's personally up to you. If you want to help your team out, go for the Sigma 2. Then I've got a stun grenade, Semtex, and the field mic, and then flak jacket, scavenger, and cold-blooded so I don't get killed by choppers, which was happening an awful lot. But that is my M16 setup. Definitely go ahead and try this out. Those were my two best class setups in Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War right now. Let me know which ones you're going to be using and share any other classes you have down in the comments below. I really want to try as many out as possible. Subscribe if you're new, smash the like button, and I will see you next time for more Cold War and Warzone.